Hello again, it's your friends at Sling Media, and today let's look at the lights on the front of your Slingbox. These lights help you in two ways. They tell you what your Slingbox is doing, and if you should ever need it, they'll help you to troubleshoot. Here's the basics. Your Slingbox has three lights on its front face: power, network, and streaming. The power light shows you that your Slingbox is getting power, of course, and next to that is the network light. It shows that your Slingbox is successfully connected to your home network. Finally, the streaming light in the shape of our Sling logo shows that your Slingbox is play-shifting TV. Let's look at what the lights do right out of the box. After attaching the audio and video cables plus hooking up to your network via Ethernet or via the built-in Wi-Fi option on the Slingbox 500, you'll want to attach the power adapter. When you first plug in your Slingbox, the power light comes on and glows continuously, and the network light flashes once very briefly. You'll notice some different cycling of the lights as the Slingbox begins communicating with your home network, but within about 30 seconds, your Slingbox should establish a connection to your home network's router. When that happens, the network light stops blinking and glows continuously, just like the power light. Now, at this point, you'll see that the streaming light is pulsing. That just indicates that your Slingbox is unconfigured and is waiting for you to set it up via watch on slingbox.com, or if you have a Slingbox 500, via the setup process right on your TV. After your Slingbox has been completely set up, the streaming light will show you that your Slingbox is in use. The Slingbox 500 has a streaming light that does a back-and-forth dance. Now, from time to time, we update your Slingbox with new internal software. This may even happen right after you hook everything up and power the Slingbox on for the first time. We're just making sure that you have the latest and greatest update on your Slingbox before you begin to use it. If that happens while you're around, here's what you may see. When the new update is downloading to your Slingbox, the network and streaming lights blink alternately, back and forth. Now when the update installs, the network and streaming lights blink together. After that, the network and streaming lights turn off as your Slingbox restarts. When the power and network lights glow steadily, your newly updated Slingbox is back online and ready to go. After the Slingbox is powered on and goes through its normal startup sequence, the network light may blink for a bit, but then it should stay continuously lit. If it either continues to blink or just never comes on, it can indicate a problem that needs to be fixed. A blinking network light typically means that your Slingbox isn't communicating with your router properly. But if the network light continues to blink or just doesn't come on at all, first check all of your Ethernet cable connections to the Slingbox and to your router. If you're connecting via Wi-Fi on the Slingbox 500, be sure to check those settings as well. If all your network connections are good, make sure that the router's getting power. You may also have to check the settings for your network bridge or power line adapter if you're using one. Typically, the best troubleshooting step to take is to restart your Slingbox and your router. First, remove the power cable to both the router and the Slingbox. Wait about 10 seconds, and then reconnect the power to the router first. Wait another 10 seconds, and then power up your Slingbox. The lights on the Slingbox will blink for about 30 seconds or so, and then the network light should remain lit. When you begin streaming or play-shifting TV via Sling Player, of course, the streaming LED will do its thing. If none of these steps seem to help and you still have a network issue, you may need to perform a factory reset of your Slingbox. For more information on how to do that, see the related video below called How to Reset Your Slingbox. Okay, that's it for this video, but if you need more help, visit our support site at support.slingbox.com or our user forums at answers.slingbox.com. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube page at youtube.com/user/slingsupport. Thanks for watching.